Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Alright. It's time to play some Fallout. Just Fallout 4. Haven't streamed in a while. And I've been doing some things. So got some things set up on the old Fallout 4. I have played this game before. I just started. I got out of the Vault 111 up there. I think I am going to stream the whole way through. I'm gonna stream my whole playthrough. Do have a few mods installed. I played the game when it originally came out on PS4. I've played all the Bethesda games on PC at some point or another. Some games only on PC, some games only on console, whatever. Some games on console first. Morrowind I played on console. I think the original Xbox. But anyways. So, I've got a couple mods, like I mentioned. The mods that I have are all of the Vivid mods, which are supposed to redo a bunch of textures, everything from water to rocks to trees, buildings, different stuff like that. Also, I think there's a Vivid Weather, so I think the weather, like maybe the clouds are different. I don't know. I've got graphics turned all the way up. I've got the game limited to 60 frames per second. I've got a G-Sync monitor. Picking, so that's why I limited it to 60. Kind of sucks because it'd be nice to see more. I've got a 1080 Ti, looking cool. I forget which one's like SC2, looking cool, whatever. But either way, I've got all those Vivid add-ons, and then I've also got like something Conifers, Commonwealth of Conifers, I think. Basically, I felt like 200 years after. Which we're going to find out soon. Spoiler alert, my bad. But 200 years after the war of 2077, which is about where we're at now, where the bombs went off, we got 200 years. 200 years have passed, and you're telling me some stinking trees haven't grown? I think Fallout 4, the way that it came was... And what little itty-bitty internet research I've done anyways doesn't really jive that there wouldn't be, like, some frickin' new trees, so... We'll see. We'll see. I haven't played with these mods at all. Just a few seconds of walking around. The conifers, you can actually have, like, no trees, a bunch of trees, or, like, a ton of trees. And I kind of did like the middle of the road one, and I felt like it was still too many trees. Like, I love to snipe Fallout 4. It's pretty easy to snipe in the original game because there's a lot of open area, and I felt like with a bunch of trees in there, it just wasn't going to be good for sniping. So, like, you know, I should be able to snipe up to the entrance to Vault 111. There's no way I would see that with the way that the mod was set up, so I dialed that back in. Or dialed it back down. I'm also using the weapon is always down mod, so you can see that the pistol when I'm not aiming is, you know, kind of down like it would be in real life. You know, if you're running around, you're not just going to run around like this all day. Your gun down, your sidearm down, whatever. And you would only pick it up when you're ready to shoot. So, let's see, I've got those mods. I've also got like the merchants have more money. I did go in. I've played all of the Bethesda games, and I've played all the Fallouts. I've played the Fallouts more than once. I just didn't feel like I wanted to go back through all the stats and build them all the way up. So I went through and I gave myself more points in my stats here than you would normally be able to start out with. I probably have like an additional 20 points than what you should start out with, so, you know, I'm kind of level 20 right now, at level 1, think it's like a game-breaking advantage, you know, like endurance. I really feel like I'm not even going to use any of those perks the whole way through the game, so I didn't give myself any additional endurance. I mean, that's my health. I'm probably never going to put another point into that. I have one star the whole game. But, like, perception, I knew that I was going to do something that was like 8 points down, which is right here, sniping. You know, so I just kind of felt like I want to get rid of the requirements. Requires perception 8, requires perception 8, perception 8, you know, the whole way through, but it has different levels, so, like, I didn't jump forward in the level, so I can't get anything that, like, right here, sniper, stage 3, requires level 26, I can't get that yet. You know, I'm not gonna jump forward. I don't know, I don't really care what anybody thinks, but that's just what I wanted to do. That's kind of what I do after I play through a game a few times. Also, like, I did just play, I'd say, about 5 hours of Fallout 4 the last couple days. I'm just kind of getting back into the groove and checking my interest level. It's crazy, I have so many games to play, and I just love the Fallout universe so much that, you know, why not play it? Why not play what I love? So, anyways, what I found was I was running into, like, these... trying to pick locks. You know, it's like, so I had to, like, bump my perception up to 4, because I had started, I think, with 1 on my last character. So, anyways, it's a fresh start. I did choose to be a female this run through. I'm usually the dude. This time I'm the chick. I built her as, like, the skinny model, which she was already pretty skinny anyways. You can do, like, heavy and muscular, I think, are the other two. You can go, like, heavy, skinny, muscular. I don't think the game straight up says fat. But, anyways, you know, so I don't know, she looks whatever, it's like a woman. But, anyways, you also may have noticed, and I just want to get all the mods out of the way here in this first video, because I'll be, you know, uploading this to YouTube later, is I did also add in this weapon. And I felt like when I was playing Fallout 4 originally that I was able to find, you know, pretty much any other weapon type, I was able to find a really cool one. I was able to find really cool pistols. Cool, like, rocket launchers, like the Fat Man, right? You find the Fat Man pretty quick in the game. Way cool, super cool melee weapons. I was able to find cool heavy weapons, laser weapons, plasma. Everything was really cool except for, like a traditional... assault rifle. The assault rifle is a combat rifle. I think they're called assault rifle and combat rifle. In the game, I think they just look so stupid. And to me, it is kind of game-breaking that, like, you wouldn't be able to find, like, an M4-based, you know, like an AR platform, M16, any of these types of weapons 200 years in the future. I mean, you tell me that they just, you know, vaporize, you know? So I did throw that in. You have to spawn it in, so it is kind of cheating right now to have this weapon this early in the game. You know, I guess I didn't even look at that, how much damage. It does 30 damage over 18, so really it's not that crazy. It's not going to kill anybody in one hit, unless it's like the weakest of enemies, you know, rat roaches, whatever. But I also added a scope mod, so I can add, like, scopes to pretty much anything. I'm hoping that kind of helps, because I thought the scopes were kind of weak and didn't seem all that right either. I don't know exactly how I'm going to do this, but I'm a big fan of sniper rifles. So I know where, like, a sniper rifle is towards the start of the game. I don't really want to, like, break the game, but I am going to, like, bend the rules a little bit. And Reba 2. Reba 2 is, like, you know, that's, like, the strong, special or legendary weapon, legendary sniper rifle, excuse me. But then it has, like, 50% damage to Mire Lurks or whatever. Get out of here. We're going to use console commands. We're going to change that over to, I think it's instigating, where, like, if the enemy has full health, you do twice damage. So then, like, I bump up my sneak attack. I don't want to, like, lower the difficulty of the game to where it's just easy, but I don't mind kind of tweaking and moving things around a little bit to fit my playstyle to how I would, you know, do in real life. Anyways, so let's see. I guess we've got a whatever. We've got my jumpsuit, and then Where's the wedding ring for my husband? I should have my husband's wedding ring. Thought. My husband is a female. Alright, Homemaker, that is another one that I got. Oh, there's see-through scopes. That's the scopes I was mentioning. It's like a, it's a different like quick scoping mod that also adds scopes. Homemaker, supposedly this adds a bunch more. Oh, Jesus, it's a holotape. Does that make sense? Oh yeah, that's just. I think the whole Homemaker thing is just in the in-game menus. But I was gonna do Junk Weighs Nothing. So I probably will do Junk Weighs Nothing, maybe by the, actually I don't even know if that mod was there, if it's in Nexus mod, but you know what, I bought my strength up pretty high, to where I'm at 270 already, so you know what, I may just, especially if I'm streaming, I don't want to take a whole lot of time running back and forth, like collecting junk and all this, I don't know, we'll see what happens. But anyways, we're not going to use that gun. Go ahead and use the 10mm pistol. I can't really think of any other mods that I'm using right now. I didn't want to do too much. I didn't want to break the game. I didn't want to make it too different. Oh yeah, the dialogue mod. So what you see Matthew, here...
Just tending the garden, Mum!
I love that. I'm just typing like this name, Maddie. And he says, "Great." Alright, so I did change the dialogue here, so that way we know which ones are a little bit more sarcastic or not. We can get just kind of like the full deal on Codsworth, what happened to the world. Oh my god, this can't be happening. This isn't happening. My god, they did it. All that fighting and for what? Everything's dead. Codsworth, you're still here, so.
Mom, you were going to say.
Still be alive too, if I can talk. Really in the morning, sorry. We wanna like keep our wits about us, so we won't make it all crazy.
Codsworth, you're still here. So other people could still be alive too.
Well, of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the hubby see you in that state, huh? Where is Sir, by the way?
Where is Sir, by the way? That fool did. Alright, let's see here. Okay, Vol, guns and strength.
They killed him.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. And I'm gonna find him. I'm gonna get my baby back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Two hundred years?
What? Are you sure?
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer.
287.
That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Okay. Yeah, so my charisma is up really high. And I did that because... Again, I've played through before. I do like being able to pick these other choices. That's how I kind of like roleplay RP a little bit. I like being able to be persuasive. I feel like
distracted
in real life,
a bit today, Mom.
I like to shut up, Cosworth. I feel like I like to kind of get down to the bottom of things. You know, I look into things a little bit more. So, overanalyze, but I bumped up the charisma. I also don't want to be like saving and like trying to go through and then I fail and I reload and try and go back through dialogue and so
Please take your time. I actually do have all day.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Mom, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Hi, honey.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome.
Empathetic.
Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
Hex to the air.
All right. Lead the way.
Let's be optimistic.
Proud to serve, Mum!
So I can definitely
not this time.
All the high-res stuff, it definitely looks better. The game is definitely pretty decent. There's like 60 frames, which is again
my senses
are
helping, but in another house. Follow me!
I think we are just gonna pick up every last item we can because there's a stand back. Let me get that. We're gonna wanna take advantage of the fact that will this show us our mods? Through Nexus Mod Manager? Yeah, it's showing. Here we go. Moscow's first versions of 26. Oh my god, there's the Commonwealth Conifers. Redux. I feel like, yeah, it looks instituted. I really wish that was down further. Controls, user controls. I don't think I really need to change anything with that.
Pin.
I don't need bobby pins yet. That's fine. We're not gonna cheat, man. We will use the console for maybe like some ammo. I'm not sure like how much I would invest with the game. So Codsworth should be over here, way over in this house over here. There he is, I can see. Really a big reason.
Miss Maddie.
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
You can't give up, Mum. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
I like these people already. See, we're not gonna do that. We're not gonna do sarcastic. We're gonna be nice.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, Mum.
Be nice to the robot.
You'll find young Sean. I know you will.
How do you know that, Codsworth? Do you know where young Sean is? I can't trust him. and just barricaded this up. Anyways, what I think I was saying was that the reason I wanted to play through the game was that when I played through it originally, I felt like the ending sucked. I think I'm gonna be okay with the ending now. I haven't like changed the ending, but I changed, I guess, my thoughts on the ending anyways.
There must be someone who can help you unlock them.
I'm kinda confused. Where are we? Where am I at? Oh, that's right. That house is gonna get demolished. But anyways, you know, I wanted to also mod it, so I haven't played, there we go. I haven't played, like, any of the mods. I played the game when it first came out. And, I did want to do scrap anything as a mod, so I could, like, clean this up a little bit better. I think I might look into, like, spring cleaning. Because, you know, it would be kind of nice to fix up the you know, sanctuary a little bit better. But I know it was one of like, the Fallout 4 script extender, and I just didn't feel like installing that. I don't know how big of a pain in the butt it's going to be. I'm kind of in a hurry right now. I'm just streaming for a little amount of time, I think, this morning. Still get to bed. Kind of getting tired. Long day. But we're just gonna basically run around and scrap like all the houses and like all the big chunks of junk that's everywhere. If it's highlighted in yellow, you can't move it. If it highlights in green, you can select it and you can place it. You can still scrap it if you want, but then, yeah, see, it's like, we just picked up the chair, kind of reorganized about the stove, this cabinet, this extinguisher, I guess we need, so the stove's good, but the cabinet's not, so, like, I can only scrap the cabinet, I can't move the cabinet, whatever, I don't really care, I'm not gonna, like, roleplay like that crazy, but, here's our fridge, it's all crappy. Basically, I'm probably leave the cars. We'll see what happens because I think with the settlement, gosh, that house just looks cruddy. But there's cars. Anyways, with the mod that I have on there, the settlement mod, I should have access to more things, which might actually include other cars. I remember at one point seeing that depending on which mod you were using, you could add cars. But just depending on when you're watching this, okay. I'm not sure why there's that much there. There shouldn't really be any bad guys here in town just yet in our little sanctuary. Let's go ahead and venture out of here. We need to start going and getting some of the items. Here we can see a little bit about what I was talking about with sniping. It's pretty big, open, wide open. And if we did have all that extra tree, all the extra trees and bushes and all that crap, just didn't add up. You know? Didn't really like it for my playstyle. Okay, so we're going to take everything we've got here, which one thing that I noticed that we got was the Drifter outfit. So we'll go ahead and put that on. I like the Drifter outfit. We'll get ourselves a nice hat here in a little bit. I like that kind of trench coatish look or long coat look to it. It's pretty cool. Okay, so we're out of our sanctuary and we're gonna go to Concord, which is right down in here. Our map is showing us that we're like right on the outskirts of this like little town. Called Concord. I did do the better map at, mod, which I'm pretty sure I talked about that earlier, but if I didn't, I was going to, sorry, whatever. But you can see the map's pretty big. And now we actually have roads that are easier to see. What's in there? So We look over here, we've got Dog Meat. He's kind of a recurring character in all the Fallout games.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
You want to come with me, pal?
You want to come with me, pal?
What's up, dude?
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
I don't know if we end up calling him Dog Meat. He's just going to be Dog the whole time. But, anyways. Okay, he's going to find some stuff. Some dog does help us. Dog Meat does help us find stuff sometimes. Items. I think he just helped us find... What did you help me find? Is there something in this room? Yeah, maybe that's right. I know if we use this terminal right here, it tells us that there's like some crap. Burnt lifestyle. Is it possible? Is that what you're trying to show? Stupid dog. Okay, yeah, come on. Let's go. We can open doors, by the way. I think there's like a stash or something. Yeah, okay, there we go. That makes sense. That's what I was trying to find us earlier, but. I just love the environment. Like, look at that truck. Like, that's attention getting. Underneath the Red Rocket Station, where we are approximately 200 years ago, they were like storing like radioactive waste down here. Set up before I actually go to Concord. I think it was along these telephone poles or whatever. There's like some raider. Okay. Shit. I definitely clicked on. cover this, but I don't really want to talk to anybody yet. I don't really want to open up any settlements and start doing any of that junk just yet. Come on. Come on. Talk to anybody. I'll take the experience though. Thank you. Thank you. And we've got that's Abernathy Farm. We still got that's right. This place over here is like the transport place. Let me see if the water gives any radiation. No, surprising. Shipping fleet locker. Okay, so we'll get some ghouls up in here. So, sounds like we can do a very good job of sneaking around. Dog meat's already attacking the ghoul over there. I suppose we can level up here. We got a point over there. I did want to be able to get advanced logs. This one is pretty much. Oh no, it is. Experience as quick as possible in this game because you are probably going to beat the game before you ever get all of the points that you want. I guess I feel is my outlook on it. So I thought there was something in here. Maybe not. See, they do some stuff like this sometimes, and you're like, oh, okay, it's like there's some radiation right by this entrance. So you'd think that I'm not supposed to be in here. Come on, dog meat. Killing me. You know, so you go, okay, well, there's some damage like right by the door. So if I take this damage, like it's like a sacrifice, and if I push through it, then some cool items for me. I got some 10mm rounds. Again, I try to take everything I can out of the toolbox. Wicked business. I feel like there's a key and like a shipping manifest or something. I think there's something in here. Now, we might not want to really get invested in what's going on here. This might be a bad idea, but we're going to go see what's up.
That's why you don't screw with the gunners.
Oh, see, they're gunners. I think gunners are bad dudes. Maybe not. Put my gun down and talk to them.
Sorry, don't have anything to sell. I'm on my way to Vault 81 to restock. Maybe you can find what you need there.
Yeah, thanks, dude. Tell me where Vault 81 is. That's what's up. So he's headed to Vault 81, which is down here. Yeah, fun. I won't be there for a while. Okay, but we can open up here. Might as well try to get some experience. Not that I'm not going to use the Protectron. Hacking, yeah, whatever. It's kind of cheater mode here. So I think you have like four options. So I just like go in and out and go in and out. Then try and do the stupid. Actually, try and figure it out. It just seems like it takes forever. Although this is taking forever. At this point, I probably should have just actually tried. This is like one of the times where it's taking me out the most. There's some experience anyways. Okay, so we've got a little bit extra ammo. Just come over here. It's not cool at all. Where did you go? Take some of that. What did you do, like Sam? That was really weird. It showed me like the health of the guy behind the one. That was actually shooting. Oh well. Alright, let's see. Dog found something. I don't really care. There's really anything in here. I think we can go behind the stairs and get to some stuff over here. Could have just got to that door too. Could also come back here and get to some stuff. Get out of there. Yeah, I already did all that, so now. That's it. Okay, I guess not. We can jump over there. There we go. Just a bunch of money somebody had with them. Some pre-war money. Okay. I really thought you were alive, but I guess not. I'll take out a 10mm pistol, some ammo. So none of this really stuff that's ringing a bell. This is of importance. This is good. Did we get the key though? Isn't there a key I'm supposed to get? Inventory, junk, mods, ammo, junk, miscellaneous.
Blake, I want you to listen to me as a brother here. This whole deal with Eddie is wicked shiesty. I mean, what kind of business partner threatens to kill you if the deal doesn't go his way? We are in way over our heads, man. I can't see a way out of this. No way except shutting down and getting out of Dodge. Give me a chance to talk this out with you face to face. I just want both of us to get out of this.
Oh, I didn't go in here yet.
October 22nd, 2077. I finally told them tonight.
Same
and it was
year.
Bad. Real bad. Dad was shouting, telling me I should be ashamed that that I had to get out of the house. Mom just cried, and somehow that hurt worse than anything else. She didn't say a word, not even when I packed my things. I can't go to John. He doesn't even know yet.
There we go.
Maybe he'll never know.
She's pregnant. Oh, it's dog meat. I think you can pick people up. Maybe not. Dog meat just runs her over. Sure. I think it's right up there. I think there's. Ooh, yep. See that guy walking. I want to be a little safe. I don't want to replay anything. That's boring to watch. So what we'll do though. Creep along here. I should come down from the other side. Usually that's what I've done in the past anyways. A couple times I start game over. But instead we'll do it this time. Okay, whatever. It's a girl. Wow, I blew her leg off. Her dog meat chewed it off. Alright, well, now we've got some stuff. Radiation. Alright, so we've got some stuff that we actually want to get rid of. And we want to get some caps, we want to get some ammo, because we're going to go to Concord and we're going to have to fight some guys. So, the first merchant that I really ever find is on my way to the diner. I will sometimes find Trash Can Carla, which is a great name. Remember. Got some bourbon, we can sell that. Okay, I'll sell all this junk. Why didn't anybody drink any of this? Some wine. Okay, we got some delicious dogs here. Let's see if we can take them out. I think I'm headed the right direction. This will be the Gorski Cabin or something, I think. Alright, let's see. We've been about 45 minutes. We'll go another 15 minutes. And call it. This will be my inaugural Fallout 4. Those are all Radstag Does. Which, this should be a bug control. Really? Did you fix that? Stinking pools around. I don't have that much ammo. I really don't want to do this. We'll see if we can't manage, though. It's not a bad start. Still have a couple more, though. Three more, so that can be. This isn't too good. Trying to make a piece of ammo here. Okay. think there's going to be more people inside. Bad guys, whatever. So let's go ahead. Oh, we got pipe this one. We got some ammo. Some guy that was messing with the radio towers down here. Last name Agorsky. Let's see, we got more ammo. Supply. We can do weapons crafting there. Which I won't be able to do for a while, but that's okay. Purified water, that's good. It comes in a can. Kill this Gorski guy, I found that. Alright, let's mess him up. Gets rid of your radiation, and then the stim pack heals you. So, take them kind of in conjunction and work together. Okay, so the diner is right over here. Down our map, for our, what do you call that, a compass? Compass says that it's right over here. Let's see, whenever you see fires like this, you know, it could be a party that you come across. To kill, or it's like just a stash. Maybe what we have here. I found, what'd you find, buddy? Bourbon. Oh, he found me drugs. Thanks. I didn't take no bottles yet. I didn't mean to take that, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, so here's the Drumlin Diner. And, oh, here's trash can. What up, girl?
Excuse me.
Hey, Carl.
So what's your story? Looking to trade? Rock?
Your money all over now. We don't want to do that.
Diamond City?
She's directions. Gonna tell us where Diamond City is.
You'll find like
the game's big hub.
Carla.
Hey there. City. Trading?
Dang right, I'm trading.
What kind of stuff?
Just a bit.
Right?
Got plenty.
Okay, alright. Let's do
Let's see what you have.
You break it?
Let me sell you some stuff. Holy shit. She has 10,000 caps. Okay, we're gonna keep those. I'm gonna keep that for right now. What are we using here? We're using 5.56 ammo. Okay, that's perfect. We're gonna get rid of some more. We're gonna get rid of all the pipe pistols because we're using 38 on that and that. And this other one does better. Okay. Now, what I like to do is as I pick up items, damn, we need to go back and get that other wedding ring. I don't know why we don't have two wedding rings. But anyways, as I pick up vodka, wine, I start puff up bourbon, Iktol, jet, these are all drugs, food that has radiation in it, we don't need to do any of that, miscellaneous, my junk, anyways, what I was saying was, what I like to do is, as I get weapons, as I get armor, I like to put just like one of them in my master's vestments. I like to put just one of them in my settlement. Okay, let's go back to our heavy grip pipe pistol. Again, we're gonna start hearing people yelling at each other.
We had a deal, Troop.
Yeah, Treaty. So save it.
Hand over the goods. You owe us.
I ain't giving you poison shilling hemp bushes anything. Do you know what that junk has done to
whoa,
my
whoa.
Boy?
Whoa, easy there, Scabber.
Hey, I'm gonna Scabber.
This doesn't involve you.
Yeah, it does.
You stop waving that gun in my face, or it's gonna involve me.
Yeah. Okay, just take it easy. We'll lower our weapons, all right? Just don't do anything crazy.
I don't need to, like...
What's going on here?
That's a simple business dispute, got it? Trudy's sitting on a pile of goods that she owes me. I tried reasoning with her, but it looks like I gotta take what's mine by force. Wanna make some easy money? Help me out. I could use another gun. Or maybe you think you can talk some sense into her.
Who's Trudy?
See that diner right in front of us? Trudy owns the place. She's converted it into a small shop. I sell her chems, she gives me caps and parts I need. And when her son Patrick had his 18th birthday, I might have sold him some jet, then some more, then a lot more.
It's not very cool.
Now he's in debt.
Jet? What's jet?
That's my top seller. Gives you a high like you wouldn't believe.
Always take a huff before
my customers
a fight.
Swear it makes him faster. Always take a huff before a fight. Well, I guess Patrick was looking to get from under his mama's skirt and be like the tough guys. So he bought some. And once you're on it, why stop? Now I've sold that boy a lot of my jet, and I expect someone to make good on his promises that I get paid.
Sounds like the family.
That's what I'm saying. You're gonna help us out.
If I help, I expect to get.
All right. I was gonna pay you $100K.
Sounds low.
Okay. 150.
Yeah. Let's see if this will work. It's red. I don't think red works.
Stop lowballing me.
I'll make it 200 caps, but that's it. Any higher, and I might as well go home.
I'll talk to her.
Maybe. Appreciate it.
I just got a bunch of money.
Hi.
I saw you in that poison cellar talking.
Okay. Why? What's this?
Oh, that chem pusher didn't tell you?
Mm-hmm.
That bastard ain't getting it.
Look, you owe the money.
All right. I'll pay. You hear that, Wolfgang? You'll get your damn money, but I better not catch you selling chems to my boy again.
Fine by me, Trudy. Your son's broke as shit anyhow.
All right. Crisis is over. If you're here to trade, step up to the counter.
We get paid, and I don't even gotta shoot nobody. Good job. Here.
Give me that money.
Now how about I show you all the pick-me-ups I have to offer?
Sweet. This guy right here. Supply lines. That's very important. You can build stores and workshops. So this one right here, supply lines between your workshop settlements. We're not going to do settlements really quite just yet, but we are going to do other things in the game. And other things in the game, I think it comes down to lockpicking right here and hacking. I think those are the two. some of this other stuff is like really nice. Whatever. I hate not being able to get into locks, so go ahead from our locksmith stuff. Okay, so we've got a bunch of ammo there. I think that's really all we actually need to get into Concord. So let's go ahead. Let's go up and start Concord. Well, we have our inventory. We're carrying almost half of our inventory. Let's go back up real quick to Sanctuary, and we'll dump off all of our inventory, and we'll be ready to go start Concord. I think I'll start Concord. There's kind of like a couple different stages, about three different stages to it. And maybe four stages. I'll do like the first stage of the mission. I'm gonna head to bed. Okay, yeah, so we got rid of a bunch of junk there. So we'll put the M2216 in there because we're not gonna use that anytime soon. We'll keep that stuff. We don't want this. We don't want this. This. We don't want any of this. Okay. And we'll get the Nuka-Cola. The Psycho we're going to end up selling. And that's about it. So now we're down to just 21 like pounds for weight, I guess. Let's go to Red Rocket. And we will work our way to the quest objective, which is the Museum of Freedom, I think. Shit. Okay. So we need to go this way as per the compass. Dog meat's kicking tires around. Alright. I do remember where. Firefighting has started. Oh, I see some lasers. I see some pew pew. What's up? What you got? Who are you? You bad? I have to mess you up? I'll mess you all up.
Now, who's this? You here to trade, sister?
Yeah, I'll trade. What's up? Yeah, what's up?
Hey.
Go talk to Dreff.
Who are you?
Name's Dreff. Now, you're here for...
Yeah. Are you a trader?
All right, yeah. Let her...
Because we're going to sell you some drugs.
Back for more?
Yeah, I'm going to sell you some drugs.
Let's see what you have.
Take a look.
I think it's Psycho. I think I want to get rid of... Yep, two Psychos. Some 50 cal rounds, some 10 millimeters, some 5.56. Stim packs, some machine guns... I kind of just want to keep building up caps right now anyways. Okay, so... If I remember right, this house right here. Should have... Snipers. Some baddies. did I just pick up? Militia hat and a Minuteman outfit. Okay, how are we looking here? Oh, we're looking pretty cool. Although, I don't think I like the Minuteman outfit as much as I like the Drifter outfit. Take the laser musket. Short laser musket. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright. Well, I think right there is where we're going to kill it. We got some good stuff done. And I'm pretty excited about that. So, I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.